Kia ora team, I'm Mackenzie.
And I'm Gabrielle.
And this is the Level 3 Calculus Complex Numbers Standard Strategy video. This standard is often considered one of the most trickier ones, and it really doesn't help that complex is in the name. However, with some of the tips and strategies in this video, hopefully we'll be able to get you through.
So the standard can be broken down into three main components, the first one being manipulating complex numbers in SIRDs. And this can involve operations such as addition, subtraction, multiplication, or division, calculating the conjugate, the modulus, or the argument of complex numbers, or converting between rectangular and polar form. And it's really important to know when you need to use each type of form as well.
The second part of this standard involves solving the equations. This can be compared to level 2, except now you've just got some unknown constants and some trickier quadratics that require some careful expansion. So you'll also get some regular quadratic questions as well that you have to solve by either completing the square or using the quadratic equation. The results of these will generally be a complex conjugate pair. Next, equations can also involve complex numbers where you have to find the roots of higher order polynomials. So the way we do this is by using an extension of Dumois' theorem to find our solutions. Lastly, for solving equations is, for excellence, you have to answer loci questions. And for this, you need to know that the modulus of a complex number is the square root of the real and the imaginary components of the equation. You'll also be told which form to put this in, and this could be a straight line, a circle, an ellipse, or a hyperbola.
So, proofs are the bane of every complex number student's existence, but the key here is figuring out what they're asking you to prove. So if it's algebraic facts, you take the most complex expression and manipulate it to turn it into the most simple expression. If it's involving roots around a quadratic, you'd use the discriminant. And if it's involving purely real or imaginary complex numbers, you'd find the complex numbers in the expression, show which part of it equals zero, and prove from there if an expression is purely imaginary or purely real.
Our first strategy for success is being comfortable with your level 2 algebra content. In particular, you want to make sure that you're really good with your fractional indices. Secondly, being aware of the fundamental theorem of algebra, which is essentially that every polynomial of a degree has exactly n roots. Now last year, you would have heard that some polynomials don't have any roots, and this is not 100% true. What it should be is that some polynomials have no real roots. Every polynomial can be written as a complex root, and because every number can be written as a complex number, there is a root to match this.
So thirdly, you have to remember the conjugate root theorem, which tells us that if every polynomial has a solution a plus bi, then it also has its conjugate solution a minus bi. So really that tells us that every polynomial has two roots. There's a lot of new terminology in this standard. And for achieved, you're going to have to remember the following terms, Argand diagrams, which tell us how to plot complex numbers on a graph in rectangular form, understanding that if z equals a plus bi, then it always has a conjugate z bar, which is equal to a minus bi, rectangular and polar form, knowing that they're equal, but are just written different ways, and also understanding the modulus and argument for complex numbers.
Algebraic manipulation of SIRDs and complex numbers is also really important to the standard. For achieve, this is simply just using arithmetic and calculating things that have been directly given to you. And for merit, you might have to find some unknown constants or complex numbers given the product or quotient. And so by doing this, you may have to do some rearranging and solving to get your final product.
When converting between rectangular form and polar form, it's good to have an understanding of the unit circle, parts of which will be given to you as special triangles. The reason being is that when you have polar form, it's nice to work in angles and radians rather than degrees, which is harder to work with. And when calculating the argument of complex numbers, they'll often turn up in nice SIRDs rather than ugly fractions.
Another key part of the standard is solving equations. A really common error that students make is when they are solving, they don't square the entire equation. Now bear in mind your fundamental algebra knowledge from previous years, and you'll know that whatever you do, you have to do to the entire side. So keep this in mind. Now, for solutions to higher order polynomials, you'll be using an extension of Dumois' theorem. It can be helpful to graph this on an Argand diagram beforehand so you get an idea of where your answers should lie. Often your answers won't be between 0 and 2 pi, and so you have to convert it into this format to get full marks. And the way we do this is by adding or subtracting 2pi. And because our function works in a loop, your answers are going to be exactly the same, so it won't affect your overall solution.
For loka equations, you need to understand what they're saying. From there, you should be able to solve any loka equation with algebra. For example, if the absolute value of some complex number is equal to the absolute value of some other complex number, then you know that their lengths are equal. Another way of saying this is that the value of complex numbers are constrained by the fact that their lengths must be equal. You should be able to sketch loci from an equation and say whether it is a straight line, a circle, an ellipse, or an hyperbola. Once you've practiced all of these forms of equations, you should be able to nail any question.
This has been our Level 3 strategy video for complex numbers, and here are some last points to sum up. Remember your past algebra knowledge, particularly that with fractional indices. Further, make sure that you square or square root absolutely everything when you're solving.
Get comfortable with drawing complex numbers. Argand diagrams are your best friend in the exams, as many of the questions will be solved graphically.
Use the remainder theorem to find unknown constants, and this gives you easy achieve points.
Be aware of the fundamental theorem of algebra and the conjugate root theorem, as these will allow you to find another complex root when given another root.
Learn and use your special triangles, or even better, your unit circles, to calculate your arguments.
Convert the solutions to complex numbers taken to a power between 0 and 2pi.
Awesome, and lastly, be comfortable with finding your unknown constants. This is going to be the bread and butter of the merit and excellence section of the standard.
Cool, so we've reached the end of our video, but we haven't actually covered everything in this unit standard, so we do recommend that you do at least 3 past exams for the standard, and also take a look at our walkthrough guides that do have next day delivery. So all the best of luck with your exams.